Good evening. Frustrated footy fans have declared the highly anticipated grand final parade on the Yarra a disappointment. The Cats and the Swans floated down the river on barges, but many struggled to catch a glimpse. Adam Hegarty reports.
Excitement in the air and elation in the lungs. The September parade's grand return, momentous on paper, but divisive on water.
And it was just a complete waste of time. All the kids lined up. We couldn't even see it. I hope there's a zoom on your camera because the boat was a mile away.
The Cats and the Swans, greeted by Melbourne's unrivalled grand final fever.
A bit different to the previous years, but yeah, it'll be exciting.
Yeah, it should be good to get on the barge.
Tens of thousands lining the Yarra, picking the right spot. The toughest game in town.
I'm sorry, but actually Perth put in a bit of better show than what they did here.
Two barges carried the bulk of players. To the naked eye, they were tough to spot, even for the most avid.
Who do we want to see today?
Bunny. Daddy.
Probably Jeremy Cameron.
Impossible for those on Prince's Bridge. With an earlier than advertised U-turn, they saw nothing but red.
I didn't even really get to see the boats because they didn't come anywhere near us. It was a total disappointment.
Got up 5:30 this morning, left from Stall, already rang the AFL and put a complaint in. It's just a fizzer.
Once the players disembarked, they got within reach. Leg two, the familiar motorcade, got them going.
Right out the front, ready for my birthday celebration.
I think it gives a lot more people vantage points to look, so it's really good.
This is what footy's all about, so it's a real privilege to be part of it.
Yet even those hugging the fences had mixed fortunes. Empty paddocks separating the cars and fans avoided. It was a sharp right turn.
A break from tradition, but still the traditional footy mad turnout. They lined the banks, the fences, even scurrying up the hill to get the best vantage point they could. Some just couldn't.
There's too much in between.
Back to the motorcade next year?
I think so, yes.
Still, for many, there was no spoiling the party. The final stretch from the Yarra to Yarra Park were at Route's End, a sight to behold. The stage surrounded, blue and white, red and white, the battle lines drawn as the anthem bled. The teams took centre stage and with them the Premiership Cup. Lucky fans given an up-close look, even if some were handing the parade's unique return a wooden spoon.
I mean, that's a good idea, but do it properly.
Adam Hegarty, Nine News.
Well, AFL Grand Final fever has returned to Melbourne. After a two-year absence, Swans and Geelong players today soaking up the traditional pre-match parade. Hundreds of thousands of fans packed the city centre, including plenty of Sydney supporters who've made the trip to watch their side fight for the flag tomorrow.
For footy mad Melbourne, this was uncharted territory. The great Grand Final parade taken from the road to the river. The Swans naturally felt at home.
A bit browner, but probably a few more people than if we didn't.
With fans lining the banks, the barges set off, snaking down the Yarra. Players then docking and climbing into cars. The stars of the sport riding high on a journey to the G.
It's what we play football for, so to get the opportunity to play in another grand final at my age is something that I don't take for granted, that's for sure.
Waiting patiently, the Swans' most faithful fans, having travelled from every corner of the country.
About 6 hours south of Perth, in a small town, about 500 people.
That's a long drive.
Yeah, a couple of days, non-stop driving, but the boys are in the grand final, you got to do what you got to do.
The festival side at fever pitch for Sydney. Excitement levels hitting a new high on the arrival of their heroes. It's an experience these players will never forget, but one they'll have to move past quickly. Tomorrow afternoon, the Swans will fight for their first premiership in 10 years.
They've obviously enjoyed the day. It'd be hard not to. It's a great day to see so many people out here. It was amazing. Part of it is just soaking it up, but also knowing when to switch back on to what's really important, and we're confident they can get that balance right.
Swans co-captain Luke Parker with one hand on the trophy today. The next time the Premiership Cup is raised, the 2022 champions will be crowned. In Melbourne, Sam Jordan, Nine News.